Hello, this is Christy. Finally, a long-requested feature has been added to Camtasia 2024, and that is ability to add dynamic captions to your video project. This is great for creating social media clips and animated captions at the bottom of your videos or burn them on the video. So let's have a look at how this feature works. So I have a video file here. It is a clip from a podcast episode with my friend Chris Menard. It's very short, but just to demonstrate how the captions work. So one challenge, of course, is that your file has to be transcribed in order to have the text on the screen, because otherwise you can't have the captions. And a nice surprise is now that Camtasia also transcribes your audio automatically behind the scenes and on your device. It doesn't use a cloud transcription service. It has its own transcription engine now included in version 2024. So let's see how this works. I have this video here. Of course, it's in the media bin. I'm going to right-click and add it to my timeline at the playhead at the beginning. So you see the file has audio and video. My project right now is 4K. I'm going to go and switch that to full HD. So here's my video. So now if I'm playing it, you don't see any captions.
I like this video is going
to... All right. So now how do you add the dynamic captions? All you have to do is go to captions on the left-hand sidebar, and there you have it, dynamic caption styles. Now on Windows, this may look a bit different. You may have two tabs at the top because you also have the ability to import captions. On the Mac, they are in a different place. But we're not going to talk about that right now. What I'm going to show you is these are some presets that come with Camtasia 2024 for animated captions. So I'm just going to grab one of these and put it on the timeline. So as soon as you add that captions clip to the timeline, Camtasia looks at the audio files and transcribes them automatically. And then as it's finished transcribing, you will see the words showing on the screen right there. And the nice thing is you can move this around and you can customize with a lot of options on the sidebar. You can change the font sizes, the colors, the transition style and speed and placement. You can make it double or triple line or, you know, as big as you like them to be. So let's have a look at all the customization options. So once you've added this, and by the way, if you want to change a specific word, because Camtasia transcribed this automatically, so you may find words that it didn't transcribe correctly, you can actually modify those, but not in this screen. What you need to do is you need to click on your video or audio file. You're talking about the audio file, because that transcription that Camtasia created is now connected to that audio file. So look at this. If I click on my audio file down here, in this space, you see now the transcription. And automatically, Camtasia will select the word you are under. So right now, look, as I'm scrolling through my timeline, you see that selection box moving. So if I want to go to a word that I want to make a correction, let's suppose that I want to change the word gonna. I want to change it to say going to, right? That's the word. You double click on it and just type going to. Press enter. There you go. That's how you correct the transcription in that little window. I wish that window was larger, but there you go. We have this. And I also wish I could import a already corrected transcription and have Camtasia automatically align it to the audio. I can only dream, and let's hope that they will bring that in the future. Now for the options to customize the captions. You can select this caption clip, and on the right-hand side, you switch to the A section, and here are the options. You can do a different font. You can change the font right there, and it changes dynamically for you on the screen. You can also change the size of the stroke or the outline of the words. You can even remove it altogether by making it no size. And then you can change the alignment of the text. You can also change the vertical and horizontal spacing. That's kind of the standard text controls that you have in Camtasia. But if you go to the dynamic caption section, you have different options here. Highlighting, you can highlight the current word, or you can turn that off. So now the captions are just going to show on the video, not animated, and you're not going to see much movement there. But if you turn that on, highlighting per word, you can now correct the word color. So basically, you've got the word color. Let's suppose that my default word color, I want it to be white. I'm going to leave it as white. But then I can change the stroke of that active word to, let's say, the size, you know, is black. I'm going to make it red for some reason. The opacity of that outline. And also, you can change the future and the past word, which means if I go back in here, you see now the word is highlighted, the current word. If I say the past words, I want them to disappear or be kind of less visible as soon as they've been said, or the future words, the words that haven't been spoken yet, I can make them more transparent or even make them disappear. So right now, what I have is the words are showing as they are spoken. Watch this.
It's going to knock it out of the park. This is a great video.
So now let's say you can change the word background. Again, the word background here, you can change it to something like orange. There you go. And you can scale that background also. You can also change the opacity so you can kind of see through it a little bit. And the radius of the corners. You can make it rounded corners on that highlight. And also you can have the time. So if you change the timing of that highlight, if you make it very, very short, there's not going to be any animation or movement from one word to another. That highlight is going to just simply go. Let's see what it looks like.
And no one cares about it.
But then if you put the time longer, then it's going to animate between the words. It's going to slide between the words. Watch this.
And then I'll make a video and I'm like, this.
And then you can also do a different options for that, like an easing. You can scale the current word, so you can have like the current word much larger. You can also make it glow if you wish. And the easing is actually quite interesting because you can have that word pop up and down as it's being spoken.
Video is just dumb. I'm making it because someone...
And the easing actually controls the duration of that.
One of my subscribers asked me to. Or...
So plenty of options in here. And you can also change the settings of the entire block of text. So for example, I can make the entire block be with a background, which is different from that active word, right? Or you can have a rounded corners for it. And what I really like is you can change the type of transition. So let me just change that scale back down. So now the transition between the different lines of text. So as the line of text changes to the next line, you can have transition. Watch this. So I'm going to go do a blur zoom. Like this might sound cheesy, but let's see it.
And no one cares about it. And then I'll make a video.
And you can control the duration of the transition right there. Or you can reverse the transition. So basically here you have access to most of the transitions from Camtasia. You can even open the entire list of transitions. Watch this.
And I'm like, this video is just dumb. I'm making it because...
So experiment with those and find the one that you like the most. And there you go. Now, finally, we can create social media clips inside of Camtasia with included caption transcription, on the screen captions. And look, if you have a desire to do so, you can even add two of these. So if you add another one like that from the library of caption presets there, you can move one in a different place. So look, you've got two of them. Both of them will be synchronized to the actual audio being spoken. And what I like also is this. If let's say that I decided on a style that I like, this one doesn't look great, but anyway, just to give you an example, you can actually go at the top and click plus here. This plus will create a preset, my favorite captions, okay? So I save this, there you go. So it adds it in here with that title. You can even add it to your favorites with this little star. So now you can reuse these presets in all of your future social media clips or videos without creating and customizing them again. So let me know what you think about this in the comments. Are you going to use it for social media clips? I know I will. And especially if you're doing vertical clips, just drag these on there and there you go. I'm so happy to have this feature now. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one.